on the mat now. Dilshod Choriev of Uzbekistan faces his teammate, Sherali Juraev. Two Uzbeks to do battle now for the under 90 kilo category spot. I'm joined by IJF Sports Director Daniel Lascar. Good afternoon, Daniel.
Good afternoon.
How are you today?
Thank you very much. I'm quite pleased today if I see the judo we have on the mat. Yesterday we had a small number of fights, but the quality was not that high like we have today. I'm just impressed about standing judo. We have seen Travis.
Wow, standing. Twice. Beautiful.
Exactly. Two Ippon scores. One Tomoenage, the other one. I was not so sure. Edisonage, I was not.
Just at the end there, yeah.
But it was a counter technique. Ott was attacking, and Travis just took over.
And I like Marcel Ott. He's a good thrower as well. He threw well earlier on. He's a good boy. Yes. Not bad.
And then the other matter which I'm very happy today, I have seen a large number of fights who were athletes. Even they get a Yuko or Wazari, they continue fighting. And I think the rules today offers to the better judoka the possibility to finish his fight. In the past, if somebody was throwing one Wazari, it was almost game over.
Done.
So you could play with the rules, you could play with the penalties. But today, because of the activity which you have on the mat, it is almost impossible if you don't have good judo skills and you don't keep the activity, it is almost impossible to throw Wazari in the first minute and to win the fight.
Another
nice Ippon.
And this time, it's Juraev who throws Choriev. The number one seed gets dumped.
Actually, particularly in this category, 90 kilograms, we have actually four Uzbek fighters.
I was impressed by one of the Uzbek women. One of the Uzbek women. She fought really well today. She's only 19. Matinyazova.
She was on the mat number
two. That's right, with the short black hair.
With the short black hair, and I just talked to the national coach from Uzbekistan. He told me she's a junior.